Welcome to Tech Insider Update.
All right, jumping into Azure AD, a pretty cool new feature that's available. It went general availability, the myapps.microsoft.com. If you have an Office 365 tenant, pop out to myapps.microsoft.com and you will see this little create button. Well, what you'll see is all the apps in your tenant, and it may look like a mess. Okay, if it doesn't, then kudos, someone's doing something right. But I'll bet you most of yours looks like a mess. But an end user can now go create their own little grouping. I called it essential apps in this screenshot. And then you can add applications that are in the environment into that little place that you contract your apps. Okay, users, end users can do that. You can also do this as an administrator. On the back end, you can create these things called collections. And you can put specific apps in it. You can target a specific group of people to see a specific grouping of apps. And so it makes interacting with the applications in Microsoft world a lot nicer. So pretty cool, go check it out. Okay, access reviews to manage guest accounts. There's a new option to disable and remove guest accounts as part of an access review. Access review is an Azure AD Premium P2 feature. So if you want to use that, you've got to have a P2 license. And this is a really awesome feature. I love it. It's the best way I know of to curate and clean up guest accounts in your tenant. Okay. The actual guest user gets an email. They can say whether they need to continue to have access to your environment as a guest user. If they don't, Microsoft will disable the guest account in your tenant and then remove it 30 days later. Okay, and so pretty cool little feature there to help maintain and manage your guest accounts. Okay, another really fun new feature. This is one of the bigger security discussions that I like to have with my clients on enterprise apps. In short, what we would tell people in the past is shut off the ability for end users to consent and onboard third-party apps into the environment, which then could read the information about that user, whatever permissions that app asked for, the user probably didn't care and said, sure, go ahead. And then they could read their mailbox, they could delete their mail, they could read their calendar, their Teams, all kinds of stuff could potentially happen. So a lot of times we would tell clients, just turn off the ability for users to consent. That's pretty heavy-handed. Microsoft now has exposed kind of a middle ground. You can require the user to type a reason why they want to use the app. An email gets sent to the administrator and they can review that application and allow that consent. They can consent for the whole entire organization, so it's a one and done. And there's a lot better path for users trying to use third-party apps to the administrator to review those and get those consented. Okay, so it's a great little piece of updates there. Okay. There's another place here where you can automatically allow users to consent to apps if they're from, quote, verified publishers, and the app is not requesting crazy lots of permissions, and you can define those permissions. So this is a relatively new thing, and there's not a lot of apps that have gone through the work to become a, quote, verified publisher that you have to get on a list of Microsoft. If you are creating an app and are interested in how to do that, let us know. We can help you through that. But another feature of this is the automatically allowing consent for the end user when it's not a high-risk app or it's been verified. Okay. All right. One of my new favorite features. I love it, except for a couple things that it's missing, and those are coming hopefully soon. But there's a new Azure AD Connect Cloud Sync engine. It's now generally available. Some of the highlights: it supports multiple agents for high availability. Today, if you're running Azure AD Connect and you have one box that can be active at a time, period in the story, that box is down, you will not sync. You can install 2, 3, 5 of these little teeny lightweight agents on-prem and get multiple, that any of them can sync up to the cloud. The management of this is all driven from the cloud side, so you don't have to get on the server, bring up the MIM console or the synchronization service console and manage stuff there. It's all handled on the cloud side now. Sync is every 2 minutes versus every 30 minutes. And the cool thing is, if you're going through mergers and acquisitions and you've got a new company and they've got a separate domain in a forest and you want to connect their identities into your Microsoft tenant, the old way, you had to get network connectivity to connect your sync engine to their forest. Now you can just drop one of these little agents in their domain and it'll sync straight up to your cloud. So multiple different forests syncing up to a single cloud tenant with no on-prem connectivity between those forests is one of its really big selling points. Awesome. I deployed that for a client 2 weeks ago. It's been working great.